Following a video I did recently on a Reddit post, I have explored a few different ways of creating this shape. I'm going to do a quick overview of what is generally regarded as the quickest method. And then I will be going more in depth into two alternative methods. For all three methods, we will start with this cylinder with a fillet. For the first method, let's start with a shell. Go to Modify, Shell. Select the bottom face and adjust the thickness. I have prepared a sketch here. The center circles defines the central portion. This is followed by a straight segment and a pair of concentric circles. I then use a circular pattern to create a copy beside it. This is to create a space between two features which we can use as a profile. From here, it is simply a matter of using these two profiles to create an extruded cut. Lastly, create a circular pattern of these cuts. Let's take a look at the first alternative method. Just as before, we will start with the shelled body. The sketch here is relatively simple. Let's use this sketch to split out the central portion. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the body. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch circle. Let's rename this body and hide it. Next, I want to split out the base using the tangent line. Create a sketch on a front plane. Project the tangent line. Go to Modify, Split Body. Use the projected line as a splitting tool. Let's rename and hide the base. Make the sketch visible. I'm going to use these sketch lines to create a thin extrude. Begin the extrude command. Select the thin extrude option. Select the straight line and a circle as a sketch profiles. Drag the arrow down to make sure that the extrude is in the correct direction. For extent type, set to all. You do not need to worry about cutting through to the base. The extrude command only works on bodies that are visible. Set wall location to center so that the extrude is symmetrical about the sketched lines. Adjust the thickness. Set operation to intersect. You can think of this as the reverse of a cut. Let's bring back the center body. You can see that a straight segment does not match up to the cylindrical face. This is because the extrude thickens in a direction that is normal to the sketched line. In order to resolve this, let's go back into the sketch. We want to extend this line beyond a circle. If we hover over the end point of the line, the coincident constraint should appear. Click on the constraint and delete. For the sake of convenience, I'm going to drag this point until it snaps to the origin. Once we confirm the sketch and let it regenerate, you can see that the gaps have been filled in. From here, it is a matter of creating a circular pattern of bodies and then combining them into one. The third method uses shelling as a main method. In this case, we do not actually shell at the beginning. Let's take a look at the sketch. This sketch was actually produced by trimming the original sketch that was used in the first method. We need to use the sketch to split faces. We need the sketch to be as clean as possible. So what we are left with here is essentially a circle and a profile that represents the space in between. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the circle. Repeat the split face command. Select these two faces. And select this chain of sketch entities as a splitting tool. Go to Modify, Shell. Select the bottom face and the split faces. Adjust the thickness. Begin a circular pattern. It would not make sense to pattern a shell feature. Once that shell has been created in that first instance, there is no longer any material to shell. We want to pattern faces instead. there is actually a small but important difference between the shell method shown here and the previous two methods. If you look at this from the top, you can see that these faces are actually not straight down. This is because shelling works in a way that is normal or perpendicular to any curved faces. So this method might be an issue if you plan to machine this. This is perhaps more suitable for a 3D printing process.